Let's do naming quickly. Tissue, if it's epithelium and it's a benign type of proliferation or neoplasia, you call this an adenoma or papilloma. If epithelium and it goes on to malignancy, you call this cancer adenocarcinoma or papillary carcinoma. Adeno, what does that mean to you? Glandular. Glandular. So where might you be? How about the breast? How about the GI tract? Such as the stomach? Such as, what if I told you distal part of the esophagus? How did the esophagus then go on to develop adenocarcinoma? Barrett's esophagus? Metaplasia was the first step of change. You went into dysplasia, you had to. Then the distal portion of esophagus, secondary to persistent GERD or gastroesophageal reflux disease, may result in adenocarcinoma. Everything that we do in basic, in every single chapter, in every single concept that we will be working together with, I'll be giving you clinical application. You cannot just look at this table and memorize it. What's the point? This is not a memorization exam. Each one of these points is a patient. Mesenchyme. We have benign, which is fibroma and lipoma, whereas if it becomes malignant, this then becomes a sarcoma. Now, when you think about sarcoma, the spread here usually, as a rule of thumb in pathology, will be hematogenous, but it doesn't have to be. But sarcoma tends to be more a hematogenous type of spread if you're looking at metastasis. We'll talk more later. Melanocytes. What does it mean when you have a bunch of melanocytes that cluster together? We haven't gone on to cancer yet. We haven't gone into actual malignancy. Nevus. Depending as to where the clusters of melanocytes then deposit, then it gives you particular types of nevi. For example, you could have a junctional nevus, you could have intradermal nevus, so on and so forth, or you could have superficial. At some point in time, if a nevus becomes, let's say, dysplastic, there's that word again, dysplasia, what does that mean? Disordered growth, increased proliferation, very much behaves like a neoplasia. Benign, we have nevus. If this nevus goes on to become dysplastic, your patient is at risk of developing melanoma. How often or how common is melanoma? It is the most popular. I hate saying that word, but it is one in which it's extremely common. It's growing. It is the fastest growing cancer on planet Earth. Could that be any more dramatic? And melanoma. In dermatology and melanoma, we'll talk about superficial, different types, acral, so on and so forth. Now, lymphocytes. If you have a cancer that is originating from the lymph node, you call this a lymphoma. Examples of lymphoma that you know of already include Hodgkin's and non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Our focus in WBC pathology, in hematology, will be specifically more so non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, because that seems to be an area with students, for whatever reason, feel confused. And well, I'm going to walk you through exactly what you need to know for what's known as a non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. For example, Burkitt's lymphoma, you've heard of before. You've heard of diffuse large B-cell lymphoma. You've heard of follicular lymphoma. You've heard of hairy cell. You've heard of all of these different types of non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. I'm going to put all this into perspective for you when the time is right.